friends, welcome to Empower, and thank you so much for watching my channel, and welcome to Anatomy 101. In this video, we're going to go over the different types of cartilage and where they're located. We will also learn about the extracellular matrix and also chondrocytes, which is the name for the cartilage cell. So we have a lot of information to cover, so let's get right into it. The process of cartilage growth is called chondrification, but at times it can be referred to as chondrogenesis, and it arises from mesenchyme tissue that has been compressed. Differentiation in the mesenchyme tissue occurs and forms the chondroblast, or young chondrocytes, that then start to secrete the extracellular matrix, forming molecules. Chondroblast precursors, or mesenchymal stem cells, are usually just stem cells and are not differentiated. These undifferentiated mesenchymal stem cells proliferate and form chondritic cell aggregates as part of cartilage formation. These chondritic cells then undergo differentiation to form the younger, immature precursors called the chondroblast that decide to stay in the lacuna and mature into chondrocytes. Cartilage in the body is usually synthesized from the chondroblast that, due to old age, are majorly inactive, opposite to the agility during the younger stages of life. Hence, cartilages do not grow due to an increase in cartilage mass content. Cartilage remodeling is mainly affected by collagen matrix change and reorganization that responds to compressional and tension forces exerted on the cartilage. Its growth is basically referred to as the matrix disposition, but both remodeling of the extracellular matrix and growth of the cartilage can occur. The majority of the skeletal muscles develop from hyaline precursors, which structurally resemble bones and are cartilaginous models for bones that grow at a very rapid rate, finally changing as they mature. During maturation, the matrix surrounding them is broken down and the precursor cartilage cells eventually die and are removed. As this precursor cartilage undergoes decomposition, there is a forming of a periosteum originating from connective tissue that usually are around the development of skeletal structures. The dying tissue is then invaded by angiogenesis, which is the way the body develops new blood vessels and connective tissue cells, which can also differentiate to form osteoblast. An osteoblast is a cell that produces the calcified intracellular matrix of bone. Eventually, this forms a spongy-like structure in the place where hyaline cartilage originally was. When a bony matrix surrounds the osteoblast, these bone cell precursors then are referred to as osteocytes. An osteocyte is a bone-forming cell that has become entrapped within the bone matrix. Then ossification, which means the process of converting tissue into bone, causes osteoblast inferior, or in the lower portion of the periosteum, to compact and form the strong bone. The process of the endophysial bone formation from the hyaline cartilage is also influenced by hormones such as growth hormone and also thyroid hormone. It is also affected by nutritional components such as calcium. The epiphyseal plate of long bone also has cartilaginous cells that form four thick layers. The first layer consists of cells which are not undergoing any growth and connects the plate to the compact bone of the epiphysis. The second layer consists of blast cells that are still in the mitotic stage, which means a stage where cell division occurs and whose extracellular matrix is still forming. And the third layer is made up of many mature cells that make the epiphyseal plate much thicker. With the osteoblasts invading, they produce salts that calcify the mature cartilaginous cells and begin to die. The last layer of the epiphyseal plate is thinner than others and is made up of cells that have already died and their extracellular matrix is completely calcified. The hyaline cartilage that remains at the end of the epiphyseal plate is considered to be articular cartilage. Articular cartilage is the cartilage that covers the end of a bone that forms a joint surface. The articulating part of the epiphysis is covered by a hyaline cartilage layer that is referred to as articular cartilage that usually forms at regions where bones articulate. Epiphyseal plates are stimulated by growth hormones that cause cartilage cell division, and they are released by the pituitary gland. In some clinical cases of hypoproduction of growth hormone, children will be affected by a case of pituitary dwarfism. Hyperproduction of the hormone, on the other hand, before ossification of the epiphyseal plate leads to pituitary gigantism in children. And in adults, it causes a condition known as acromegaly that leads to large feet, jaw, and hands. Epiphyses of long bone is the site for hematopoiesis, a blood component forming procedure that occurs in red bone marrow when a person matures. Hematopoiesis moves into flat and long bones from the liver and the spleen. Another hormone is the thyroid hormone called thyroxine that causes the removal of hyaline cartilage in the epiphyseal plate. Overproduction of this hormone can lead to epiphyseal plates to ossify prematurely. Hypothyroidism, on the other hand, causes stunted growth since it has a positive feedback on the pituitary gland to release growth hormone for maturation. The parathyroid hormone, also another thyroid hormone, also causes osteoclast hyperactivity, which leads to the breakdown of bones, making them weaker. All right, guys, I really hope you liked the video going over the different types of cartilage. Make sure you stay tuned because in the next video, we're going to go over how many skeletal muscles develop from hyaline cartilage. We will also learn about osteocytes or bone cells, and we will also learn about the effects of hormones on bone growth and development. So you definitely don't want to miss that, so make sure you stay tuned for that video. Also, if you are studying for anatomy physiology, I'm sure you've realized by now how much information it is and it can be very overwhelming. So if you're interested, I do have a program that outlines exactly how I aced this class, and I've helped thousands of other students do it as well. All you have to do is become a member of the channel for only $5 a month, and of course you can cancel anytime and you will have access to this program. All right, guys, I will see you soon in the next video. Bye.